weeks ago. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. It's the day of the Lord. Nothing can hold us down. Nothing can hold us captive. The Master is with us, and the shout of kings is in our midst. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Welcome everyone online in your homes. I can see some people right now. Can I begin to call your name? I can see you in your home. Please just do me a favor right now. Just give somebody beside you a big hug on my behalf. Just tell them that I love them with the love of God. Oh my God. I wish I could just hold all of you one by one and just hug you right now. But just give somebody a big hug for me. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you.
Amen.
The Lord make his face shine on you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Glory to God. By the special grace of God this morning, we'll be looking at a topic, redemption by exemption. Redemption by exemption. Can you say it right now wherever you are?
Redemption by exemption.
Okay, I can't hear you clearly.
Redemption
by exemption. Please open your Bibles with me to 1 Kings chapter 17, verse 1 to 7. 1 Kings 17, verse 1 to 7. 1 Kings 17, 1 to 7. I'm waiting for you to open it. I just want every one of us. I'm reading it in Message version. 1 Kings 17, verse 1, all the way to 7. And then this happened. Elijah, the Tishbite, from the settler of Gilead, confronted Ahab. As surely as God lives, the God of Israel, before whom I stand in obedient service, the next years are going to see a total drought, not a drop of dew or rain, unless I say otherwise. God then told Elijah, get out of here and fast, head east and hide out at the Kerit Ravine on the other side of the Jordan River. You can drink fresh water from the brook. I've ordered the ravens to feed you. King James says, I've commanded the raven to feed you. Elijah obeyed God's order. He went and camped in the Kerit Kayon on the other side of the Jordan. And sure enough, ravens brought in his meals, both breakfast and supper, and he drank from the brook. Eventually, the brook dried up. I'm reading up to 9, sorry. Eventually, the brook dried up because of the drought. Then God spoke to him again. Get up and go to Zarephath in Sidon and live there. I've instructed a woman who lives there, a widow, to feed you. May the Lord bless the reading of his word in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Don't forget, the topic of this message is redemption by exemption. Redemption by exemption. The story that I just read to you, the scripture that I just read to you, is about Prophet Elijah. Prophet Elijah. Prophet Elijah lived in a crucial time in the history of Judah and Israel. Elijah suddenly appeared. Nothing was said about who gave birth to him or anything. He suddenly appeared. The Bible actually introduced him as, you know, from the settler of Gilead. You know, Elijah from Gilead. You know, he suddenly appeared. His name means Yahweh is my God. Elijah means Yahweh is my God. You know, he lived in the time when Ahab was the king of the northern part of Israel. Ahab government officially supported worship of Baal and gods and other small gods. So in those days, it was not popular to serve the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. The children of Israel, they derailed from the service of God who brought them out of Egypt. They derailed from the service of God who moved them past through the Red Sea, you know, Jordan. The mighty miraculous things that the Lord did in their lives. They abandoned the God of heaven and earth and started to worship Baal in those days. It was a crucial time in the history of Israel. It looks as if the worship of true God you know, might be completely eliminated. It was as if the enemy was gaining upper hand over, you know, the will and the purpose of God for the people. You know, the prophet of Baal gloried in their sudden rise to power, in their insolence and greed and debase. The fire of persecution was lit so much that even people who genuinely trust in God dare not open their mouth. Everyone was in hide, as you know, in hiding. The whole land was apostate. Of all the thousands of Israel, only 7,000 people had not bowed their knee to kiss the Baal, who is their mini god at that time. Even the people who professed to be Christians, many of them, they were quiet, you know. Elijah, later on in 1 Kings, he was saying, God, I am the only one. And God said, no, man of God, you are not the only one. There are 7,000 people who have not bowed their knees to Baal. He thought he was the only one. Now, let's come back home. This was in the time of the Israelites. It was in the time of the northern kingdom of Israel, when Baal seems to be the only god that everybody was worshipping. And let me say this very quickly, you know, the fuel of the dominion of Baal was actually aggravated by the queen then, who was Jezebel. Everybody was just worshipping Baal. Can we just bring this home today now into our different, you know, into our world today, in Canada, in your locality, in the world at large? All conversation, they go on smoothly until the cross is mentioned. You can talk about the weather, people can talk about their dog, they can talk about their cat, they can talk about their jobs, they can talk about their vision. But the moment you mention God of heaven and earth, the moment you bring the Lordship of the Lord Jesus Christ into the conversation, all conversation stops. I don't want to hear that, you know. Let's see the similarity between those days of Elijah and our days today. We have taken religious studies out of schools. Oh, in those days when I was in school, you know, there is a religious studies that people study, but right now, religious studies has been taken away and replaced with social studies, you know, for our children. All our youths, they find it easier to go to the pub on Friday and sleep in on Sunday. That is our days now. We have shed innocent blood in the name of policy. People find it easier to consult, you know, horoscope, palm reader, wizard, witches, that looking for answers in the King of Glory. Pastors have changed their messages on the pulpit in our present day to suit the need of the major titles in their church. Messages, something like rapture, we also don't hear it anymore. We don't even hear the message of salvation anymore. Everything has gone under the banner. We don't even hear about holiness and purity. When was the last time we preached about this? Oh, we are in the end time, brethren. I want to remind us that we are in the end time. You know, legacy of faith and hope and love have been buried by our core fathers. Our aged population have been neglected. Many of them are in nursing home, where they are barely visited by their parents. Many of them, even in their nursing home, they have spent every money that they have saved for their retirement in taking care of themselves. This is the world, the reality of the world that we live today. God has a way of using something like COVID-19 to bring everybody back to the cross. God has a way of using not so good situation to bring people back on track. And it's a wake up call for the church. It's a wake up call for the church. With the devastating effect of COVID-19, you know, it's very hard even for Christians to stay focused right now. Many of us, we are living in fear. Many of us, there's so much uncertainty. Many are wondering, how do I pay my mortgage? Many are wondering, how do I feed my children? Many are wondering, at the end of this, am I still going to get my job? There is so much uncertainty in the air. Practically, it looks as if the entire world is dropping down. It looks as if the entire world is closing on us. Oh my God, I was watching yesterday on news and I see people falling like flies, you know. People just falling down and dead, you know, in China. Oh brethren, we are in the last day. Many people, even including yourself and myself, we're beginning to wonder, those fantastic and marvelous things things that we wrote down, the beginning of this year, those goals that we are termined, the things that we want to accomplish this year, we're beginning to wonder, will these things be a reality at all? If things begin to go on this way, these are the questions in the mind of everybody. And you know, sometimes I am a little bit hesitant in praying against certain things. You know why? Because we cannot pray against prophetic agenda. When there's an agenda that God is fulfilling in this end time, we cannot pray against it. Open your Bibles with me to Luke 21 verse 11 in Amplified Version. The Lord Jesus Christ himself said, he said, there will be mighty and violent earthquake. Luke 21 verse 11. There will be mighty and violent earthquakes, and in various places, famine and pestilence, plague, malignant and contagious or infectious epidemic diseases, which are deadly and devastating, and there will be signs of terror and great signs from heaven. So, this is a reminder to say, you know, whatever is happening around us today is fulfilling prophetic agenda of the end time. But I have a message of hope for the church today, and that message of hope for everybody that is watching me online, in your home, whether you are a member of HOP or you are not a member of HOP, as long as you are a child of the Most High God and you are born again, you see, there is an exemption for you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can I hear a bigger amen? Come on, say,
amen.
I am exempted.
I am exempted.
Come and say, I am exempted.
I am
come
exempted.
And say, redemption by exemption.
I am redeemed.
Come and say, I am redeemed to be exempted.
I am redeemed.
Can I tell you that you are exempted from whatsoever is going on around? Because where you live in your home is Goshen. And in Goshen, you are safe. In Goshen, you are secure in the name of Jesus. Devil may be reminding you of how lonely and isolated you are right now. He may be telling you, you don't have a wife. You don't have children. You don't have anybody around you. You are all alone by yourself. I'm here this morning to tell you that you are not alone. The King of Glory is with you. The Lord of Lords is with you. You are not alone. Psalm 37 verse 25 says, I have never seen the righteous forsaken, nor their seed beg for bread. You will not be abandoned in this situation.
Amen.
God is there with you. Come and say, redemption by exemption.
Redemption by exemption.
Some people may say, there is no hope right now. There is no hope. Where do we go from here? I'm here this morning to let you know that there is hope for a tree, even if it be cut down and the root wax old on the ground, by the scent of water it shall bear. Come and say, there is hope for me.
There is hope for me.
And some people may be saying, oh my God, what is the future for our children with all this that is going on around? I'm here this morning to say, there is future for you. Hallelujah. Oh God said, he said, I know the thoughts that I think towards you. He's the thought of peace and not of evil, to give you a hope and a future. Hallelujah. Somebody may be saying, there is darkness around. Oh, here is the word of the Lord for you. Psalm 60 verse 2b and 3. For behold, darkness shall cover the earth, and death darkness all the people, but the Lord shall arise upon you. Can I hear amen?
Amen.
Come and say, the Lord is arising upon me. The Lord shall arise upon you, O Jerusalem, and his glory shall be seen on you, and nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your rising. Hallelujah. King shall come to the brightness of your rising. Yes, no darkness shall cover the earth. Don't cross darkness the people, but the Lord is arising upon you. Hallelujah. Some people may say, what if I caught coronavirus? You won't catch it. But you know what? Even for any reason, it touches you. Remember, Malachi 4 verse 2. He said, the Son of Righteousness will arise with healing in his wings. I declare you healed in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I declare you healed in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So God has already given us an exemption package. Hallelujah. We have an exemption package. Brethren in the home, listen to me. You have an exemption package, not insurance package. What you have is an exemption package. Insurance package is if it happens, we're going to take care of you. But what God is giving you this morning is an exemption package. That 1,000 will fall at your right answer, 10,000 by your left answer. With your eyes, you will see the reward of the wicked, but it will not come near you in the name of Jesus Christ. It will not come near your home in the name of Jesus Christ. You are safe and secure in the hand of the Lord in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So you have an exemption package. Use it wisely, not an insurance package. So the story that we read today, Elijah, he declared the drought. He declared the drought by the leading of the Holy Spirit. He suddenly appeared on the scene as if from nowhere. He said, as long as the Lord God of heaven liveth, before whom I stand, there shall not be rain or dew for the next 3 years, except by my word. He suddenly appeared. And you know what interests me there is this. It was the one that caused the drought, but God took care of him. Hallelujah. But you didn't cause COVID-19. Hallelujah. You didn't cause COVID-19. How much more will the Lord take care of you? You didn't eat bat, did you? No, you didn't. It didn't happen in China. You know, but even for Christians in China, I am trusting the Lord. As many that declare the Lordship of the Lord Jesus Christ, they will be exempted from this plague in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So he confronted Ahab. Why the exemption? He confronted Ahab. As surely as God lives, the God of Israel, before whom I stand. And you may want to ask, God is not, he doesn't exempt people for the fall of it. Why are you going to be exempted? Why? Why? What is the purpose of God? And this is the core of my message today. What is the agenda of God in this end time? Why is God exempting us from the plague, from the pestilence, from the noisome pestilence that is going on around? What is the purpose and the plan of God for the church? Come with me as I begin to tell you one by one the purpose of God. Number one, the purpose of God is for us to confront every evil that is happening around us. Amen.
Amen.
God wants us to confront every evil that is going on around us. What did Elijah do? Elijah did not keep quiet in the corner of his room and say, I'm cool with my children. I'm okay. It doesn't really bother me. As soon as I'm fine and my children are fine, I'm good. No. God, Elijah confronted Ahab. It's time for the Christian world. It's time for the redeemed of the Lord to begin to confront every evil around us. He declared it loud and clear. As surely as God lives. As surely as God lives. He declared that God is still a living God. Hallelujah. I'm here this morning to let you know that God is still a living God. God is still a living God. Over coronavirus, God is a living God. Over COVID-19, God is a living God. In our school, God is a living God. In our offices, God is a living God. In every home, in every marriage, in your future, God is a living God. The God of Israel, he said, as surely as God lives, he said, I don't care what is going on around. I'm going to just be that one man person who will declare the Lordship of the Lord. I challenge you today, wherever you are, on your Instagram, on your Facebook, whatever you are using, begin to declare the Lordship of the Lord Jesus Christ around you. He said, as long as the Lord God of heaven lives, he confronted evil around him. How many of you agree with me that God lives? It doesn't matter the legislation. It doesn't matter the resentment against the gospel. He lives. He lives in my home. He lives in my body. He lives in my marriage. He lives in my parenting. He lives on my job. When I go out, God lives. When I come in, God lives. When I'm sleeping, God is living. In my speech, God is living. On my Instagram, God is living. In my Facebook, God is living. God lives. That is the first thing God wants us to do in this moment. God wants everybody to become an evangelist. Whereby you declare the Lordship of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, if we have publicized the Lordship of Jesus, the way we publicize COVID-19, oh my God, COVID-19 won't be an issue by now. Anything that comes, I can't tell you how many, in 30s, I received so many messages this past week regarding COVID-19. Let's not make it about COVID-19. Let's turn it around as the church of the living God and make it all about the Lordship of Jesus Christ. Can I hear you say, Jesus lives?
Jesus lives.
He lives in me. He lives in you. Let's declare the Lordship of the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, as long as God lives, the God of Israel, oh my God, the God of Israel. The God of Israel. Can you declare God as the God of Oyedirun's family? Can you declare God as the God of Muyiwa's family? Can you declare God as the God of Samantha's family? Can you declare God as the God over your family, the Damani's family? Can you declare him as the God of Oderoke's family? He said, the God of Israel. Hallelujah. For this God is a God forever and ever. He will be my God from now, even unto the end. Sing it along with me. For this God, for this God is my God forever and ever. He will be my God from now, even unto the end. Elijah said, the God of Israel, before whom I stand, before whom I stand in obedient service. He declares that God lives. He took his spiritual stand, even though he was in front of Ahab. Hey, he refused to recognize that Ahab was, he was standing, he knew he wasn't standing before Ahab. He said, before whom I stand, the Lord God of Israel, before whom I stand. What is the second thing God wants from us in this time of COVID-19? God wants you to take your spiritual stand. Hey, can I tell you, until you take your spiritual stand, you may not be exempted. You know why? Because in your spiritual stand, you are meant to sit together with Christ in heavenly places, far above principalities and power. So if anybody asks you, where are you standing? You are not standing in Canada. You are not standing in Guelph. You are not standing in Wellington County. You are not standing in Waterloo. You are not standing in Cambridge. You are standing, meant to sit together with Christ in heavenly places. Take your spiritual stand. He had a right standing with God. Take your spiritual standing. Take it, take it. Take your spiritual stand. Take your spiritual stand. When you have a right standing with God, you need no introduction. Hallelujah. Can I say I hear that? Yes. You need no introduction. When you are standing before the God of heaven and earth, take your spiritual stand. In the home, gather your children together. Educate them that there is redemption by exemption. Many of our children don't even understand what we're talking about. Let them know that their case is different. Right? The blood that runs in their veins is the blood of Jesus Christ. And that blood, coronavirus cannot supplant the blood. Hallelujah. Let them know. Let them be. Take their stand. He said, before whom I stand. For whom I stand. The reason for your exemption is not for you to sit down and cool, but to take your stand in these times and season. Hallelujah. To take your stand in this time and this season. Use all the medium at your disposal to declare the word of the Lord. Oh my God. All through this week, I was listening to this song that says, these are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. These are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. These are the days of Elijah. Hallelujah. These are the, where are all the Elijahs of God? Where are all the tongue-talking Christians? Where are all the tongue-talking Christians? This is the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. Declaring, what are you declaring right now? Don't declare fear. Don't declare anxiety. Don't declare uncertainty. Don't declare hopelessness. Don't declare agitation. Declare the word of the Lord. Oh, I love Elijah. Elijah said, I don't care if nobody wants to serve the Lord. As for me, I'm going to serve the Lord. Elijah declared the word of the Lord. And you may begin to ask me, Pastor Lola, what is that word of the Lord for now? You know the word of the Lord for now. Repent and be converted, every one of you, that a time of refreshing may come from the presence of the Lord. What is the word of the Lord that you need to declare at this moment? The word of the Lord that you need to declare is that righteousness exalts a nation. Sin is a reproach. What is the word of the Lord that you need to declare at this time. You need to declare the Lordship of the Lord Jesus Christ. You need to declare that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, he's the same today, and he's the same forevermore. Oh, what is the word of the Lord that you need to define? You see, you need to declare. I was looking at the word COVID this past week, and I said, God, give me a personal acronym for COVID. And the Lord gave me C stands for come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. C stands for come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. A stands for we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. O stands for we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. V stands for thou hast walked through the valley of the shadow of death, and we fear no evil, for thou art with me. That rather that serve, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemy. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup run over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. What does I stand for? It's not by power, it's not by power. D means you will declare a thing, and it shall be established, and the light will shine upon your path. Declare the word of the Lord to your children. Declare the word of the Lord to your colleagues at work. Declare the word of the Lord to your neighbors. Declare the word of the Lord when you are walking on the street and you meet somebody. Just say, Jesus loves you. Jesus cares for you. Declare the word of the Lord. These are the days of Elijah. Where are the Elijahs of God? The God of Elijah doesn't go to bed. The God of Elijah is not sleeping. Wake up from your slumber. There's an idea in your spirit that the Lord wants to use in this time. It's time for you to put it into practice. These are the days of Elijah declaring the works of the Lord. Oh, these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. I challenge you to begin to restore righteousness in your home, in your office. Begin to restore righteousness. Stand for God, even if it costs you your job. Stand for God, righteousness being restored. How do we restore righteousness? Husband occupy their place as the husband of the home. Wife occupy your place as the wife. Children occupy your place as the children. Don't be negative towards each other. Don't be resentful towards each other. That is how to declare. That is how righteousness can be restored, even if it costs you your job and your life. Stand for righteousness. And these are the days of great trial, of famine and darkness and sword. We are the voice in the desert crying. Do you have a voice? I give you a minute to pause about that. We are the voice in the desert crying. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. God needs your voice at this time. God needs your voice at this time. These are the days of Ezekiel. The dry bones becoming as flesh. You can begin to speak into every dryness. We can speak unto coronavirus and it will die. Hallelujah. These are the days of Ezekiel. He prophesied unto dry bone, and the dry bone raised up. On and on. These are the days of your servant Moses rebuilding a temple of praise. Let's rebuild the temple in our home. Let's rebuild the temple of God in and around us. Hallelujah. 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 These are the days, you know, these are the days of harvest. The field that is white in your world, we are the laborers in his vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord. I challenge you. The second thing is for you to take your stand and be the hand and the feet of the Lord Jesus Christ. What do you do in such a time like this? Don't forget, number one, declare the Lordship of the Lord Jesus Christ. Number two, take your stand, your spiritual stand. Let people know where you stand. Don't stand in the fence. It's either you are on the Lord's side or you're on the devil's side. But I encourage you this morning, take a stand with God. Don't be two-faced. He said, if you are neither hot nor cold, I will spew you out of my mouth. Take a stand for God. Let people around you know that you are an ambassador for Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. What is the third thing that we need to do at a time like this for our exemption to be real? Elijah attuned his ears to divine instructions. Elijah, he attuned his ears to divine instructions. he was able to hear God. He declared the drought. God swung into action, but he needed to hear God to be able to know what to do. Attune your ears to divine instruction. What is God speaking to you as a person in the now? What is God saying now? Listen, forget about what God said last year. Forget about what God said yesterday. What exactly is God saying to you now? Revelation is in layers. When you look at the life of Elijah, it was by the brook. God told him, go to Brook Cherith. I have commanded the raven to feed you. But not only that, after some time, you know the brook dried up. It would be very foolish of him to say, God, you brought me here. I'm going to die here. I'm going to stay here. But no, God spoke to him again. He attuned his ears to divine instruction. God said, no, now that the brook is dry, I need you to get out of here and go to Sarephath. Many of you are lying by the brook that is already dried up. Get out of there. Sarephath is waiting for you. The window of Sarephath is waiting for you. Many of you are pending a job or a job. Some of you are doing a business that is already dead. God is saying, let it go. You know, the most difficult thing to break is tradition. This is the way we were doing it since the time of Baba Kidayomi. That's the way we are going to be doing it. You are missing it. Revelation is in layer. You have to be open. You have to be open. You have to be mendable. You have to be pliable. My husband will always say that. Mendable and pliable in the hand of the Lord. You have to learn to learn, unlearn, and relearn. Hallelujah. That is the secret of the kingdom. We can't box God to the corners of our brain because he led you certain way yesterday. It's the way he's going to lead you today. No. He attuned his ears to divine instruction. He attuned his ear to divine instruction. How attuned are you to divine instruction? How attuned are you to divine instruction? What is God saying to you right now? What is God saying to you right now? Declaring the word of the Lord. 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 Be the hand of the Lord. Be the feet of the Lord. Let the Lord use you for his glory. Let the glory of the Lord. Another thing also for you to know. Don't forget. Can I ask you to say it after me? Number one, declare that God lives. Number two, what? Stand. Take your spiritual stand. Number three, attune your ears to divine instructions. Number four, value your hidden life now. Hey, you didn't get that. You must value. See, God is hiding you now for a reason. You must use the value of your hidden life now in order to launch into your next level. Listen to me, church. God, why? God gave me five reasons. Number one, to teach us to celebrate the giver more than the gift. Can I hear amen to that?
Amen.
To teach us to do what? To celebrate the giver more than the gift. If you say this gift, this brook share it, you will drink water, whether you like it or not. You are God asked me to come here. No. It wasn't crying and fasting and praying. Many of you are in a relationship that has dried up already. Let it go. A friend, you are holding on to this friend. We started secondary school together. University, she was my bridesmaid, and you kept on having problems with them. Let it go. That's your brook shell. It's dried up. Go to Sarephath. There's a fresh supply there. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
To teach us to celebrate the giver more than the gift. Number two, to trust the giver, not the gift.
Amen.
To be able to trust the giver, not the gift. Number three, to loosen our root so we can find him as the main source of our life. Hallelujah. To loosen our root so that we can find him as the main source of our life. Number three, he wants to put a river in us that can never dry. Brook Cherith may dry up, but there is a river. Remember that scripture in Psalm? There is a river, the stream that makes glad. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. There is a river. Out of their belly shall flow rivers of living water. He wants to put Cherith inside of you. You know, so it's not about your location now. It's about what is inside of you. Because if it's inside of me, anywhere I go, spring will be available. Hallelujah. Yeah. Another one also is to give us a new revelation of Him. A new revelation of Him. At this time of COVID-19, I want to challenge every family that is watching me. Please take note of all these things. I know I may be a little bit fast, you can listen to it again. Take note of everything that I have said today. Number one, declare the Lordship of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's number one. Number two, take your stand. Let people know where you stand at this time. You are seated together with Christ in heavenly places. Be like Elijah, declare the word of the Lord. Be like Moses, righteousness being restored. Be like David, rebuild the temple of praise. Many of you, your family altar has been crumbled. It's time to rebuild the family altar. It's time to call your wife and your children together and begin to rebuild the altar. If you are alone in the home, it's time for you to partner with the God, the Father. Hey, I love that. Oh my God. God, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Because you are not, you see, it's the sweetest fellowship you can ever think of. Hallelujah. Yeah, that's the time. That's the time. That's the time. That's the time. Be like Moses. You know, I want you to be like Daniel. Hey, dry bones becoming as flesh. That problem that has been staring your family in the face, it's time for you to go into your war room and fight that problem and declare war on that problem day and night. In between of your walking from home, schedule 5 minutes where you put the book aside and say, Manda Karabo, Rekekekekekeke, and fire that problem. Hallelujah. Resist the devil and it will flee away from you. Oh my God, you know my God, in this time, I'm going to turn my entire family into prayer warrior by the end of this month, by the end of stay at home. Hallelujah. I wake up every morning, before I will leave them, they will sleep up in our 6 a.m. prayer. But right now, I leave my bedroom, I go upstairs, I sit in between my 4 guests, I say, you see, you see, you see, and we are praying together on the line with other people. So that's my goal, to turn everybody into a demon chaser, devil crumbling, I don't know what adjective to use. Jesus, caterpillar, and warrior. Thank you, Bravo. That's my goal. To make my family a terror to the kingdom of darkness. And I see my husband now. He practically lives in his prayer room. Please, let me beg you more. I need some love. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I love you with the love of God. Take your stand. Take your stand at a time like this. He declares the lordship of the Lord Jesus Christ. Not only that, he attuned his ears to divine instruction. Value your hidden life. God will use anything or anyone or any circumstances to meet your need. Be where God wants you to be at this time. And don't forget, revelation is in layers. Let God do something beautiful in your life. So at the end of the day, see, this is what I want your testimony to be. I am the woman that the Lord took to the top, regardless of COVID-19. Can we rise up on our feet? Can we rise up on our feet? Can we rise up on our feet? Let's just begin to worship the Lord. Let's give Him all the glory for this wonderful moment in His presence. I can feel you. Please don't play, don't play. Just begin to worship the Lord. Just say, Lord, please give me hearing ears. Make my life, let my life be changed. Let my life be transformed, oh God, by the reason of this situation, Lord. Let my life be transformed. Let my marriage be transformed. Let my home be transformed, oh God. In the name of Jesus, can I begin to pray unto the Lord? Begin to pray unto the Lord. Malika balu deleke te 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 te. Rika balu deleke lebo zakaraba. Maruka ba nendo kete kene lebo. Rima zuta kaliga lebo. Rika ba zumoriente kene le. Ila busa kane lebo shakaria na namaya. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' name, we are praying.
Amen.
I have 3 prayer points, you know, to raise. I just want you to hold somebody beside you wherever you are. Just hold somebody beside you. Hold somebody beside you as a big family of Entropy. And for all our viewers online, we just want to pray together. Hallelujah. The first prayer point you're going to say, say, Lord, I surrender to you. Whatever you are doing in this season, Lord, don't do it without me. Shall we begin to pray unto the Lord? My God and my Father, whatsoever you are doing in this season, Lord, please don't do it without me, Lord. If you are healing in this season, don't heal without me. If you are delivering people in this season, don't deliver without me. If you are saving lives in this season, don't save without me, Lord. If you are exalting people in this season, don't do it without me, Lord. Oh Lord, I lay myself as a living sacrifice before you. Daddy, use me for your glory, Lord. Use me for your glory, Lord. Use me for your glory, Lord. For your glory, I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as my king. Yes, for your glory, Lord. I will do anything, Lord. I will do anything, Lord. There is that vision the Lord has given to you. Begin to say, Lord, find me ready in your hands, oh God. I will do it, oh God. I will fulfill my destiny. My time will not be wasted in this season. My resources will not be wasted in this season. My talent will not be wasted in this season. In this season, Lord, I will be the best that you want me to be. A new woman is emerging out of me. A new man is emerging out of you. A new child, a new marriage, a new daughter, a new social worker, a new mentor. He's emerging out of me, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
I love the way you are praying. God bless you. I love you. I can feel you right here. The second prayer point you are going to pray, Lord, I attune my ears to divine instruction, Lord. I attune my ears. Lord, speak, Lord. Speak, Lord. For your servant is hearing. Speak, Lord. Speak, Lord. I open up my heart unto you. Speak, Lord. Shall we begin to pray? Marika ba zoto kelelebo. Speak, Lord. Speak, Lord. Speak, Lord. Speak, Lord. Speak to my heart. Speak to my heart. Bypass my human reasoning, Lord. Supplant my human reasoning, Lord. Oh, speak, Lord. Speak to my mind. Speak to my soul. Speak to my spirit, Lord. Make it clear. Every spiritual cataract, every spiritual wax, I remove you from my ears. I will hear God. I will hear a voice behind me saying, this is the way. Go in it, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Speak, Lord. Speak, Lord. I will not be rebellious. I will not be rebellious. Father, speak, 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 Lord. Speak to my heart, oh God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name, we are praying.
Amen.
You see, I know you are a fabulous husband, but you know what? There's still the best is still yet to come. I know you are a great wife, but you know what? Good is not good enough. The best is not even best enough. Revelation is in layer. You are going to pray and say, Father, let the best come out of me in this season, Lord. Let the best come out of me, Lord. Let the best come out of me. Shall we begin to pray, Lord? Let the best wife to my husband, let it come out of me, Lord. Let the best mother come out of me. Let the best social worker come out of me. Let the best mentor come out of me. Let the best writer come out of me. Let the best pastor come out of me. Oh, there is a death of you I have not known. There must be more to you than I have not known. Yes, Lord. The working of your spirit, Lord, is what I desire, Lord. Oh, teach me, Lord. Teach me, Lord. Teach me to love you more. Teach me to know you more. Let the best get out of me, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. Begin to wave your hands unto the Lord wherever you are. Just thank God for this moment. Give him all the glory. Give him all the honor, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. I see the Lord making your life beautiful. I see the Lord making your life colorful. I see the best of you coming out. No sickness will ravage your body. As many that have been affected by COVID-19, we speak wellness unto them. We speak healing unto them. Unto our governors and minister, we speak wisdom in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, let your glory be done, oh God. Have your way, Lord. Bond our family together. Add more families to us in this time, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Lord, we celebrate you, Lord. We celebrate you. 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 We celebrate the Lordship of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, not a day goes by without His unfolding grace. I see some unfolding grace in your life. I see some unfolding grace in your marriage. I see some unfolding grace in your business. In the name of Jesus. Oh, hear the word of the Lord. The Lord asked me to tell you, you will not be embarrassed. You will not be embarrassed. You be embarrassed. You will not be embarrassed. God asked me to tell you, I've gotten your back. I have your back. I know this will happen. I have taken care of you and all that you need. In the name of Jesus Christ. Riba saka de gelebo. Rika taka de gelebo. Maruke te gelebo. Rinda ni kalabo saka de gelebo. The Lord asked me to tell somebody, as you go before the Lord and you declare judgment against that sickness, it will vanish. It will miraculously vanish. It will miraculously vanish. In the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord asked me to tell somebody, this is the time for the evangelist in you to rise up. Oh, this is the time. This is the time. This is the time that you have been waiting for. This is the time you have been waiting for. The Lord asked me to tell you that idea that I gave you, it's time to put it into practice. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. Oh, we worship you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. Lord, you are higher than any other.
Our God is healer.
Oh, yes. Awesome in power.
You are